Hi students, in this session I am going to teach you top 10 tricks from thermodynamics and thermochemistry chapter. Let us see the first trick. Coming to the work done calculation problems. We have two processes. One is irreversible process, isothermal irreversible process. Another one is reversible process, isothermal reversible process. For both the process, formula is different. For irreversible process, formula is different. For reversible process, formula is different. For irreversible process, formula is W is equal to minus P delta V. And for reversible process, formula is W is equal to minus 2.303 nRT log V2 by V1. As per Boyle's law, volume is inversely proportional to the pressure. So, minus 2.303 nRT P1 by P2, we can take the formula because pressure is inversely proportional to the volume. Coming to these two formulas, which formula you have to use? In a question, if irreversible word is there, you use this formula. If irreversible word is there, you use this formula. If suppose no reversible, no irreversible is given, then how you have to use a formula? Which formula you have to use? When no reversible and irreversible is given, you have to use a formula for reversible process formula. Isothermal reversible process formula you have to use. If suppose any word like constant external pressure, or if any word like suddenly, if it is given in a question, then you need to use the formula W is equal to minus P delta V. So don't confuse. You simply use this simple trick and you can find which formula you have to use. Let us see the trick number 2. Whenever you use the formula W is equal to minus P delta V, pressure is in unit is atm, volume unit is liter. So you get the units, atm liter is a unit you will get to the answer. But in options, atm liter won't be given, and if joule is given, then how you do the conversion? One is simply the trick is you have to, actually that is a method, you have to multiply with 101.3 joules. This value, you remove this atm liter and multiply with 101.3, then you will get your final answer in a joules. This is a way. Let us see why you have to multiply 101.3. 1 atm is equal to 1.01325 into 10 to the power of 5 newton per meter square. This is a 1 atm value. And 1 liter is equal to 10 power of minus 3 meter cube. So 1 atm liter is, multiply both, 1.01325 into 10 to the power of 5 newton per meter square into 10 power of minus 3 meter cube. If you multiply both, you will get 1.013, 10 power of 5 minus 10 power of 3, so 10 power of 2. This is newton meter per meter square is there and top meter cube is there, so it will be newton meter. Then it is 101.3 newton meter, which is newton meter is nothing but a joule. So you will get the answer in a joule. If you replace this, if you want to get the answer in a joule, remove this 1 atm liter with 101.3. Let us see the trick number 3. Whenever you are solving the questions based on the work done, you will confuse with the signs, because in physics and chemistry, signs are different for work done calculation. Work done by the gas or work done by the system or by the gas is negative in chemistry. Work done on the gas or work done on the system is positive. These are the two signs. And when you are solving any question, that in a question, if work done, only work done calculation is given, find work done is given. So that time, for example, you are using for irreversible process, isothermal irreversible process, you have taken this formula and you got the answer. For example, minus 5, you got the answer, atm liter. Then you check the options, my dear students, see minus 5, plus 5 and 4 and then if suppose 6, like this 4 options is it. So work done, they are asking. Then you get the you got the answer minus 5. So tick the option, mark the option 1. For example, in options, if suppose minus 5 is not given, magnitude is not given. Options are like this 5, 5 and 4. 3, 6, like this. You got minus 5, but in options, they did not take any sign. Magnitude, you directly 5, you have to tick in those cases if sign is not given in a options. And next point, if suppose in a question, work done by the system itself, it is given. They're not asking work done. Directly, they're telling work done by the system. If suppose in a question itself, that by the system word is there, trick is, you know, need to take a negative sign in options again, because in a question itself they are telling you the sign by the system. So in those cases you have to take only 5, not a minus 5. This point is most important, where student feel a confusion. Is it clear? If not, pass the button, again watch the video. Let us see the trick number 4. Let us see the formula as per the first law of thermodynamics. Delta E is equal to Q plus W. Why I am discussing this formula? Because formula is different in physics and chemistry. In a physics, the formula is delta E plus W is equal to Q. So when you in chemistry, you have to use only this formula. If you use this formula, it will be wrong. Why it is like that, I will tell you in a regular class. But here I am discussing you the main point here. Delta E is equal to Q plus W. What is the delta here? Is a change in internal energy. Internal energy. Which is equal to Q plus W. Suppose Q is equal to delta E minus W, which means that whatever the heat absorbed that is useful for doing some work, and remaining energy is stored as an internal energy. That is the meaning of this. And here, if you do any sign convention wrong, then your answer will be wrong. So make sure that heat absorbed is positive, work done by the gas is negative, work done on the system is positive. And one more point I want to discuss with you. Delta E, here we kept a delta symbol, but see students, we didn't put any delta before a Q and before W, because delta means which is a change. Here enthalpy is an state function which depends upon initial and final states. That's why we write delta E. But Q is a path function, and work, heat and work, both are path functions. They don't depend upon initial and final states. That's why we don't write a delta symbol for these two. This is important. These two are a path functions, and internal energy change is a state function. Let us see the trick number 5. Here I'll tell you two important formulas. One is heat absorbed at constant volume. Heat absorbed or heat change at constant volume, or heat loss at constant volume. QV is equal to nothing but change in internal energy, which is equal to NCV delta T is the formula. Number of moles will be given in question. Specific heat capacity at constant volume will be given in question. Change in temperature, initial temperature, final temperature, both will be given. Final minus initial you take and you substitute it in such a way you can calculate the internal energy change delta E. NCV delta T is a formula. What is that? Heat change at constant volume. Heat change at constant pressure. Heat change or heat absorbed at constant pressure. That is what? Delta H. That is nothing but enthalpy change. That is QP. You can write like this, or you write QP. Or better, you can write small q and a p, which is equal to NCP delta T. Heat capacity at constant pressure into change in temperature. Both the values, all the three values given in question, and you can find it. By substituting, you can find it. Clear? And by using this two, we have one more formula. Let us see the trick number 6. Let's see the relationship between delta H and delta E. Delta H is equal to delta E plus delta nRT is a formula. Okay, delta E you can calculate by using this formula. Indirectly they will give you the data. You can find the delta E, substitute over here, and one reaction will be given like this. See how a reaction will be given. For example, combustion of methane. This reaction is given for you in a question. Are you following? So first balance, it will be balanced reaction only given in your question. Okay, so you no need to confuse anything. And now what you have to do is just find the number of moles of the change of gaseous products minus reactants. What is delta NG? Change in number of moles of products minus reactants. Only gaseous products and reactants. You should not consider solids and liquids. So only one gaseous product and here two gaseous products. So delta NG value is minus 1. Substitute in this formula and you can find delta H is equal to delta E minus 1 into RT. So this is your main formula. You can solve some easy kind of questions directly like this, or some questions they want to give interlink with this, means they give interlink with this and you can solve the question. Let us see the trick number 7. Let's see the trick number 7. This is a trick regarding related to thermochemistry. When coming to the enthalpy of formation, I'm going to discuss three formulas. One is enthalpy of formation, another one is enthalpy of combustion, and another one is enthalpy change of bond dissociation energy. So in these three formulas, I want to discuss with you, because students do correctly, but only signs they will get you when you are doing, you get only sign convention wrong. That's why once go through this formula in detail. Already I made one video regarding combustion and formation, so I'm not going to discuss clearly, but formulas, what are the main formulas I'm going to discuss. What do you mean by enthalpy of formation? Formation of one mole of a substance, you know, from their constituent elements. For example, you want to make one mole of CO2. Then how can you make one mole of CO2? CO2 exists as a gas in atmosphere. So this is a natural state. It is formed from a carbon. It can be formed from oxygen. Carbon exists in a graphite state in nature, and oxygen exists in a gaseous form. So this is an enthalpy. This is the formation of one mole of a substance, CO2. How to write the formula for this? Enthalpy change during a reaction is enthalpy of formation of CO2 products minus reactants. That is enthalpy of formation of what? Enthalpy of formation of carbon, which is a graphite state, plus enthalpy change of formation of oxygen, which is in gaseous state. In such, I taught you slowly in the video of enthalpy of formation and combustion. Go through that. This is what? Product minus reactants. This is a formula. Coming to the combustion, for example, you want to combust one mole of ethane. Then what will be your product? CO2 and H2O. Just balance this reaction. C2H6, two carbons and three hydrogens, six hydrogens, 2 2s are 4, 7, 7 by 2 O2. This is a reaction, balanced reaction. Okay, now for this formula is enthalpy change of enthalpy of combustion of ethane. Formula is actually it is a product, reactant minus product. Reactant minus product is a formula. So first you need to write the reactants. Enthalpy of combustion of ethane, first reactants, it plus 7 by 2 into enthalpy of combustion of oxygen. These are products, reactants. Okay, reactants minus products you need to write, my dear students. Enthalpy of combustion of CO2, how many moles are there? 2. Plus 3 into enthalpy of combustion of H2. I taught you clearly how to write this expression. Okay, reactants minus products. Coming to the bond dissociation energy, means while breaking a bond, in a question itself, how much bond dissociation energy or bond enthalpies will be mentioned in a question itself. Bond enthalpies. Okay, bond enthalpies. In those cases, the formula is reactant minus products. So if it is given with respect to bond enthalpies, enthalpies, you have to use the formula reactants minus products. So use these formulas, you don't get any wrong in your calculations. Is it clear? Now let us see trick number 8. In trick number 8, I want to discuss with you enthalpy of neutralization. What do you mean by enthalpy of neutralization is when one equivalent or one mole equivalent of or one equivalent of an acid is reacting with one equivalent of a base, both reacts and it forms NaCl and water. Okay, during this process, some amount of energy is released. That energy is minus 13.7 kilojoule per mole or minus 57.1 kilojoule per mole. This much amount of energy it released per a mole. So here when acid is reacted with the base, this is a energy will be released. This is called as an neutralization energy. Enthalpy change during a neutralization. And whenever, here the trick is, whenever instead of a strong acid, if a strong base like a HCN is given, instead of strong acid, if a weak acid like a HCN is given, in those cases energy released will be less than minus 13.7 or it will be less than minus 57.1 kilojoule per mole. So in options you have to check that which is less than minus 13.7 or minus in a kilojoules, that option you have to mark. See here, kilocalories per mole. This is kilocalories per mole. This is kilojoule, this is kilocalorie. So if you are taking in a strong acid, strong base, here minus sign indicates that some energy is releasing out. Now let us see trick number 9. Second law of thermodynamics says that entropy of universe always increases. Entropy of universe always increases. So here entropy, universe entropy is nothing but system entropy plus surroundings entropy always increases, so which is always greater than zero, because universe is nothing but a system entropy plus surroundings entropy which is more than zero. So here the problem is you have to calculate both the entropies, delta S total you need to calculate, then only you can find whether the reaction is spontaneous or not. So total entropy is greater than zero, then the reaction is spontaneous reaction. Why it is like that, I'll teach you in a normal class. Entropy of universe, I'll put in video completely on this particular second law of thermodynamics, that time I'll teach you. If delta S total is less than zero, then the reaction is non-spontaneous reaction. What is that, my dear students? It is non-spontaneous reaction. If delta S total is equal to zero, then the reaction is at equilibrium. So in such a way, you need to find the total entropy, system entropy plus surroundings entropy. But it is very difficult to find both the entropies. That's why we use a Gibbs energy formula. Delta G is equal to delta H minus T delta S. Here we use a system entropy only. Here system enthalpy. So easily by seeing this you can find it. If we'll substitute all the values given in a question, if delta G value comes negative, then the reaction is spontaneous. If delta G value comes positive, then the reaction is non-spontaneous. If you get here delta G value zero, then reaction is at equilibrium. So no need to calculate here total entropy. System entropy, if you calculate, it is enough. By using Gibbs energy change, we can find whether the reaction is spontaneous or non-spontaneous. Spontaneous means the reaction which takes place on its own. Non-spontaneous means the reaction will take place with the help of some external force. Okay, let us see trick number 7. This is regarding phase transformations. For example, solid converts to liquid. This is called fusion. Liquid are converted into gas boiling, or solid converts into, you know, directly gas, then it is sublimation. So during this process, how can you calculate delta S? Delta S is, if these reactions all takes place at, see, S is equal to Q by T is a formula, right? And all these reactions takes place at a constant pressure. I already told you, heat absorbed at constant pressure. What is the formula, my dear students? Heat absorbed at constant pressure is nothing but enthalpy change. By here, temperature is constant, delta H by T. This is, you are telling, for solid to liquid, so it is a fusion. Delta H fusion by T, it is given in a fusion, will be given in question, temperature will be given in question, this is will be given in Kelvin, okay? Then you need to find entropy change, that's it. And if suppose you are doing for a melting, or you are doing for a boiling, liquid converts to a gas, then you need to use a formula, delta H boiling BP by T, because surroundings temperature is constant. Then this is a formula of second law of thermodynamics. Formula of second law of thermodynamics, integration of dQ by T is a formula. Okay, if surroundings temperature is constant, bring the temperature out and do integration of d of Q. D integration d will be cancelled, differentiation will be cancelled. We will be having Q by T is a formula of delta S, entropy change formula. Okay, now you here, if the reaction is taking place at constant pressure, you have to put a P here. QP is nothing but delta H. Use these formulas directly and you can solve. In this video, I covered these tricks. I'll make one more video. In that, I'll try to cover few more tricks. I hope you, these tricks will be helpful for you. Copy all these tricks in your notebooks. Whenever you have some examination on thermodynamics, go through this. I already made some videos like bomb calorimeter, enthalpy of fusion, irreversible process work done calculations. Please go through all those videos before your thermodynamics exam. Really, these tricks will help you a lot for getting a good score in your examination. My name is Komali. I'm your chemistry mentor. I thank you so much for watching this video.